On Earth, there are over 100 different species of endangered animals, some of which have unique spot patterns. We can use the same NASA technology that is used to map stars to track endangered animals called algorithms. Algorithms is a process in which triangles are formed with stars at the vertices. Then each star is represented as an XY coordinate. An algorithm is a process that matches as well as compares star configurations within the Hubble telescope's images. This process can also be used to track animals that have unique spot patterns, such as polar bears with their whisker spots and whale sharks with the spots in skin. There are plans to use this process to track animals such as polar bears, whale sharks, and Mola Mola, the ocean sunfish. Ironically, the star mapping algorithm is so accurate because it pinpointed stars, it had to be altered to be less accurate to be able to map spots. What they did was apply blob extraction. This pinpoints single color pixel groups. And this was needed because whale shark spots are much larger and more irregular in shape than stars in photographs. Also, they used contrast enhancement elements, which clarified photos and helped with their perspective issues, because the sharks are hardly ever photographed in the perfect form. Other forms of tracking animals have proven to be dysfunctional after a couple of months. Holmberg built a database system called EcoShin. This is a whale shark photo identification library that collects photos of whale sharks from researchers and tourists and compares and identifies the sharks to each other. From this, scientists learn more about the migration path of the shark and the status of the whale shark's population. Thanks to the algorithms, scientists are learning that whale sharks are not as massively migratory as they were once thought to be. According to Jason Holmberg, a software programmer and technical writer, scientists are challenging a lot of previous conceptions about whale sharks. Without the help of tourists, this plan will be hard to accomplish. Photographs taken by tourists are used when matching photos with the data. As Jane Waterman, the associate professor of biology and one of the principal investigators of the Polar Bear Project, says, they all become our field assistants in a way. According to Holmberg, we used to get a few hundred documented sightings, but now, in just 1 year, we get over 2,000. Scientists are collecting much more data in a faster and more convenient way by using tourists, as opposed to collecting the data themselves. By having and using this process, astronomers can map stars, and scientists can track certain animals as well as compare and identify them.